Hey everybody, Asher here, back with more. Hey everybody, Asher here, back with more Ark Survival Evolved, where the sun is rising and casting through the trees. Here we have our little hut house, and all it needs is a roof. And we're going to be continuing today, like I said before. There's going to be a little bit of play off camera eventually, and a little bit on. But I think for the earliest parts here, probably best for me to do some of this on camera, just so you can see. Now, what I'm doing right now is farming thatch and wood, because I do need to make some thatched roofs and everything like that. So we'll see how far that goes. But we have a few other goals here as well. I want to be working towards taming a dinosaur, preferably a dillo or something early on. But I think some of the good advice that I've gotten just from the Reddit community and the community in general, which has been pretty good and helpful, as long as you're asking the right people the right questions, is just to... Okay, we have some interesting wind blowing mechanics here, but really what we're going to have to do, I guess for lack of focus all of a sudden, is we got to get our materials together and we've got to farm, because you can see our XP is at 62.9 out of 70, which is going up a little bit, and as I harvest resources it does go up just a little bit. So we'll need to make that a thing here. But like I said, I just want a lot of thatch, because the next level I'm going to put thatch roofs, and then we're going to talk about killing and hunting dinosaurs. But like I said, good advice that I got before. And it is something that I'm going to try and stay true to as best as possible here, though I am going to have to repair this pickaxe in just a second. So here, I should have the materials for it. Is what don't you want to do when you're in this game, is that you can run into the habit of trying to explore a little too far, press yourself too far. Sometimes it is okay just to stay close, as we got really loud music. Let me hop into that. Options here. I do have the settings all really low, but apparently I'll have to report that, because this is early access. I hope they do take my reports into consideration as well as other people's. But wow, the all my volume things are down, and that was just really loud, so I apologize if that broke somebody's ear. We got way more flint than we need from that rock. But here we go, beautiful sunrise. It's a new day. And as soon as we get the experience necessary to do it, we are going to be crafting or getting some new Ingrams here, such as, and we're going to have 8 points available, which should be enough both for the thatch roof and then the slingshot, assuming I hit level 5 next, which comes after 4, so that's pretty good. Now I do have plenty of food available, and there are some options that you can take here. So I'm going to just look at my map here and see, okay, we're kind of on the eastern side of everything, and this is I don't really know the best way to describe what update I'm playing on right now, but one of the first things that I can do here as a player is try and stick to the coast just a little bit. And what I want to do, well, first off, what I'm going to need to do, and I'm a little wary to do this because this is how I've gotten myself killed in the past pretty hard, is just jump into the water enough to get my water meter back up. Now it's cold a little bit, but you can see just by jumping in the water like that, I'm now hydrated. So there's a nice obelisk over there. We have some cloud scatter as well. We have some big things that can beat the crap out of me. But we don't really have to venture that far. I may do some server play here in a little while. So we have a pterodactyl up there. That's not what it's called, but that's not really what I'm going to be doing. But we'll do a little bit of exploration this way. Like I said, I just want to fight some things on the coast, because that is a good way to level up. Going into the woods can be a little bit dangerous. And I am already pretty close to being fairly encumbered, so I do want to have... There we go, there is a dillo available. Now, I don't have enough meats and everything to try and tame him, but... And the dinosaur that's behind there is a really good riding dinosaur from the start. In fact, it looks like there's two. So it looks like we have a fight on our hands here in just a moment. Let's get the hatchet out, although I don't want to lose the hatchet. It's nice, even since the earlier updates, we have all kinds of new things available, like new skin colors and everything. So you're going to die here in just a minute. Hopefully we can surface strafe to not get hit. Now, I didn't play a lot of Elder Scrolls, so I'm not the best at my first-person combat, but I'm going to want to start farming some hide here. By the way, that's not how you want to take these guys on if, in fact, you're trying to... Well, first off, we're about to level up, which is part of the point of doing that encounter. We're going to walk back to our house. Probably by the time we get there, we'll be okay. But yeah, I didn't play a lot of Elder Scrolls, and when I did, I didn't necessarily have it in me to do all the first-person precision combat like that, so this is a little bit of an adventure. And I'm still working on the fact that sometimes you can hold E. But you're going to see that I'm going to try and keep as many Narca berries as possible. Because as we farm those, as long as you keep it in a stack, things spoil only one stack at a time. Like my meat is potentially going to spoil. I should probably eat some. And cooked meat is good for taming if I want to tame a Dillo, but I don't have the level or the equipment yet because I could punch it and knock it out. There we go. There's our level up. We'll make sure we're at a safe place before we level up because I think we're going to, yeah, we're going to keep getting experience anyway. So level 5, one of your first big breakpoint levels. And like I said before, you don't have to worry so much about like getting a thatch roof, making a thatch house and everything. But since I am just sort of playing by myself, we do have a dodo down there as well. We'll make that happen. Let's go ahead and we're going to level. What are we going to level up here? I've already gotten melee damage up. Let's go ahead and upgrade our health one more time. And then we have the thatch roof, which the only reason I'm getting this is because I am going to need the thatch roof to end up unlocking things like wood stuff. Because wood is the first structure that you really want to do. But slingshot, oh no, slingshot takes 6 EP. I swear it used to be 5. But that's okay. We'll save our EP points and then get some pretty substantial unlocks the next time. Because we do want to start banking those. We do want to get a mortar and pestle. Also very important. We cannot necessarily get some of these things later on, but the nice thing is that even if you die, you do get to keep your levels. So how are we going to level up in this game? First off, like I said before, you can level up by crafting. So if we just craft a, where is it? Thatch roof times 2. If we just go to our inventory, it should be there. We do have one raw steak right now. We don't want to worry about it too much. My bigger concern is that we're going to be fairly close to our encumbrance. Which for those of you who do not know what encumbrance means, it means the amount that you can carry before you can't really move around. So let's go ahead and put this up here. Let's put this one over here. And we have a house. If I just shut the door right now, any day now, there we go. End of episode. You can see we have the little home icon. It's a thatch wall, owner Asher. If I do that little help meter, it doesn't really do anything for us here, but I'm going to go ahead and take this off just in case we do bad things later on. But see, we have metal, which is a pretty precious resource. And we are carrying most of our weight right now is stone. But we're actually going to need more stones. What we don't need as much of is wood. The reason we're going to need stones is that if we're going to be using the slingshot, we're going to need actual stones that we can pick up to take it out. But I did see a dodo over here. And while I'm good on food resources right now, if I'm going to be trying to tame a Dillo, what I need to start doing is killing things for meat. So that means I'm going to need, well, there's two things that I need. I'm going to need some hide. And you can tame this guy as well. I could punch him and knock him out, but that's not really what I want to do. So Dodo, you're dead. Sorry, I killed the Dodo. So there's some hide right away. We're going to need a lot of hide before this is all said and done. So we are going to kind of explore the coastline just a little bit. We want to keep getting narc berries and all that. Because how you tame things, it's pretty simple. You hit them with a blunt weapon of some kind, either your fist or trank arrows when you get them unlocked eventually. Or more likely in the early game, you get a slingshot and you use stones and you pelt something in the face. And the more damage you do to it, and this is where trank arrows are really nice, the more damage you do to it, you have what's called taming effectiveness. And hopefully I'll be able to demonstrate this as we get leveled up enough to actually craft things and make it work. Based on the taming effectiveness that you have, and it's on a percentage sliding scale, if you do too much damage, you're either going to... Well, you do a few things if you do too much damage. You can injure the animal to the point where... Or the dinosaur to the point where its stats are pretty poor, and it's not a great dinosaur to tame. Plus, it gets harder to tame because it takes more resources to do it. But still, once you knock it out, you want to use narc berries or narcotics or something else, depending on where you are in the game for what you can craft. And this is a really narrow inlet right here. Am I being attacked right now? No, that's just me jumping. All right. So see, we got dinosaurs right here. Dinosaurs, there's a game I haven't heard, or a TV show I haven't heard anyone talk about in a while. And we don't want to go too far north because some of these guys can get fairly aggressive if threatened. Right now they're my friends. Those are actually a pretty worthwhile tame. And we got three of them. I'd love to take this guy on, but the only problem is he runs. He runs like crazy. See, if I hit him right here, they're gonna run. These guys just do not defend themselves at all. And see, we're getting a little bit of lagginess here. But maybe I got him cornered. Maybe we got it. There we go. We killed. We got a new hatchet. Now see, that's how you want to take that out. He's going to run, but if you can get him kind of cornered here, we're okay. So I'm going to need meat, but I need hide a little more. More importantly, if you saw how much my experience went up for this, it's kind of like Monster Hunter. If you played Monster Hunter before, and I've played quite a bit of Monster Hunter in the past, you hack at these things. You kill them, and then you hack at them some more, and we have bizarro lag a little bit. Like I said, this game gets updates quite a bit. It actually got a pretty substantial update today. At the time of this recording, I had to wait for the update to go live. They did just introduce the Quetzalcoatl. But you see right there, there is a Brachiosaur. I don't think I saw one last episode, but that tells us where we are on the map. That we are in slightly more dangerous territory than maybe we were before. And the Brachiosaur is something that I can tame. I could probably even tame it with some help if I was playing online. And I want to get just a little bit of a closer look, just so I can show you all the beauty, the majesty of something that's going to make some really big poops. But there it is, just walking along. We have some dillos down under. In fact, I wouldn't be... Look, it actually took down a tree. But you see, we have a few dillos roaming. And in fact, I wouldn't be entirely surprised if they tried to ankle bite that Brachiosaur. And the dinosaurs will actually fight each other. They will fight for their life. But you see, this is... And I don't have a magnifying glass or something to zoom out in a little further. But I count two or three dillos right there. And that can cause quite a bit of problems. Or if I do unfriendly fire. So I don't think that's the best place to really engage. I'm still pretty low, pretty early in the game. So while I do have some good resources, I'm just hoping for some decent respawns. Like some of these guys right here, they could be good, but if I keep hacking into them, it's going to be a problem. What my goal is, okay, I have a few goals. That's the nice thing about these survival games is that you have goals upon goals that have their own goals. I want to make something where I can tame a dinosaur. I want to make a bed so that I can save. I got to get a sleeping bag so that I can make the bed. Fortunately, sleeping bags don't cost too much in the way of resources to get. So we are going to have to drop probably some wood here in just a little bit. But you see, we're just picking up all the berries all the time. Could be decent for me to actually tame a herbivore at some point. So that may be what I do first, because right now we are ever so slowly but surely leveling. Here we're at 82.5 through 120. Like I said, all I want to do is to find some dinosaurs and have some fun with them by hitting them in the face. So we could run a little faster here, but let's just carry on. We're going back to the house. And I'm kind of just trying to stick to one area. See, we're encumbered now, so what items do we not really need here? Those stem berries are pretty heavy. We don't really need thatch too much. So if we shift click, drop item. Okay, we didn't want to drop all the thatch. We want to split the stacks. I mean, thatch is pretty easy to get, but if we take the wood, there we go. Shift drag. You know, we'll just unload all this weight right now. We need stone, we need hide. Some of this other stuff will be fairly easy to come by, especially when we have all this fiber right here. So we can even get rid of a torch as well. So now we're up to 72 weight. It's mostly stone, so I need a place where I can store my stone, because right now all the things that I've dropped here, it is going to decompose after a little while. In fact, let's go and pick up this wood, because we're going to need the wood here before long. And let's just see if... What I want to know is, and it's like this in other games, and I want to say it's like this here, but I've never actually tried it. If I drop something in my house... Oh good, we have spoiled meat now instead of raw meat. If I drop something in my house, it's not going to decompose, or will it decompose? I guess there's one way to find out. Like I said, I was really hoping we have our nice little straw hut here. was really hoping that we get some more dinosaurs to whack on. I mean, I did see a whole bunch up there, but with the Brachiosaur, you just gotta watch it. So, hello, Dodo. But I'm gonna be keeping some raw meat here. Some of it is gonna spoil, but that's just the nature of it. Okay, run, Dodo, run. Too slow. You're encumbered. There we go, lots of hide. So we are partially encumbered, so I'm gonna need to increase my weight just a touch. But let's try dropping the wood stack in here. There's enough trees around here that I'm not too concerned if I do lose some wood, but I do wanna have plenty of stones. We're getting some of this other stuff together. So, inventory's too heavy to jump. That's hilarious. All right. So let's try dropping. So we have 60 thatch. We do have 40 wood. If we drop it in our house, still decomposes in 2 minutes. All right. Well, you know what? That's 20 weight off of our back. Is there anything else that looks like it's going to be really heavy for us? That's a lot of charcoal. When I need wood, I can just get a little more wood, because right now, 32 of that weight is stone. I don't know if I'll need 64 stones, in fact, so let's go ahead and... I just want to split the stack. There we go. We just drop these. Did I just drop all of my stone? Nope. All right. Pick up the wood. See, we're learning a little bit together, but it's going to be okay. So split that stack. I don't know why that didn't happen this time with this. There we go. So we don't need too much of that stuff. What we need to do is kill things. Like these dodos, because that's the experience that you get. Bigger dinosaurs, little dinosaurs. I guess I'm a bit of a dino bully, if I'm just picking on the weak, but isn't that the point? So one more hit. Hey, at least the dodo's not extinct, right? Now we got plenty of raw meat too. So this is kind of a good double whammy. You get your raw meats, you get your hide. And you make it work. I do have some more dinosaurs over here. I'm really trying to keep a lookout, because you can start to get some dangerous things poking out of the woods a little bit. But I think right here I'm okay. This is where we fought that Dillo ever so bravely before. Alright, so let's poop, because poop is fun! You can't have an episode without poop. And we got another dinosaur over here. We've got... looks like two of them. We got something big in the water. That has killed me before. Now the question is, if there's two of them, are they going to try and defend? Probably not. These guys are usually runners. So they're usually runners. So you're going to run away and run into the rock wall. There we go. So like I said, I feel a little bad. I really do. But on the other hand, I need the experience and I need the resources. So these guys are by far, they're like the cattle in a way. And they're really good to tame, just to try and ride with a little bit later on. But it looks like we have not too much in these woods just yet. Still very impressed with how this game runs on my system despite the crash last episode. Alright, so what do we got up here? Not a lot. Just a little full. So if we go around this bend, you can see once again that we're kind of relegated, because there are big nasties in the water over here. And if we poke our head in, maybe we can see them. Nah. We got a few things in the water, but nothing too exciting. See, we got dodos. We got stuff we can kill here. And we're still pretty well within range of our original home, so that's nice. So let's just do a little bit more farming. And then I think I may pick up this episode around once I get left. And we can start going into the taming a little bit more, because taming, very important. So there's a level 12 dodo. And we're using the axe to get hide, but we're getting a lot of raw meat too, which is pretty good. I'm going to need quite a bit of raw meat if I'm going to be taming a dillo, as you'll see in the next thing that comes. Oh, you actually tried to fight me back. How brave. Level 8 dodo. I got out-leveled by a dodo bird. Let's just keep that in mind. My current level is 5. And we have... Okay, we got something here. Once again, I'm not sure if the pterodactyls are aggressive or not. I'm not really super inclined to try and find out. I don't think they are aggressive towards me. But I don't want to get so close that I just get owned. What I want to do is get this guy. Because dinosaur hunting, that's what it's all about. Survival means we take on the herbivores and run from the carnivores. It's very simple. The things that want to eat you, you don't give them the opportunity. So there we go, right into the rocks. A little bit of lag, which is probably just from some other good things. I've noticed with this patch, some of the optimization that I had before is dissipated just a little bit, but we should, good. That increase in melee damage does add up over time, so. Another pentasaur, more hide. And we're doing all right. Got a lot of hide, in fact. I'd say we're doing a little more than all right. So there we go. I'm gonna call this one, as we have a nice view of the blue obelisk. It looks kind of purple, but it's blue, indigo even. But yeah, that's it for now. This is Asher just hacking away. We actually one-shot a dodo, probably because I headshot it. But yeah, thanks for watching. That's it for now. We will continue next time with more Ark, where you see some of the more bigger dinosaurs over there. I can try and take some of them on if only I can make my way across the river. But right now it's farm time, and when I catch up next episode, let's just jump right into taming. I think that's probably the most interesting thing for you all at this point, because it's one of the things that really sets Ark apart from other similarly situated games. So once again, thanks for watching, thanks for sticking around. Feel free to leave your thoughts in the comments. Still trying to look for a good, healthy server to kind of move on to and play online, especially with some viewers or other people. So if you got some suggestions, feel free to leave it in the comments. Otherwise, you can leave me to my devices as I hack away some more things that were supposed to be extinct. Take care. See you next time.